Hi, Andrew here from Markertek with another instructional video. Today we're going to be building a guitar cable using quarter inch connectors. We've got the Neutrik silentPLUG, which allows you to plug and unplug your instrument without any noisy pops. And on the other end, we're going to be putting a standard Neutrik quarter inch plug on. For that, we're going to be using some Canari GS6 guitar cable. I've got jacket strippers. I've got some flush cutters, needle nose pliers, some wire strippers, and a nice little pick. We're going to be using a vise, some lead-free solder, and our soldering iron. I love these connectors as a musician. I play bass, and it is really great when I'm switching between upright and electric to have a silent plug. It's a lot better for the audience. The sound engineer loves it because you're not hurting his speakers, and you can go freely between instruments without having to wait on anybody else. So let's jump into it and get building. All right, so first thing we want to do is get our connectors out so we can put our boots on. Take the boot, slide it over the cable, get it out of the way. All right, we can move the other parts out of the way for now. And now we're gonna prep the cable. So I'm gonna take my jacket strippers and take off about half an inch on each side. So now I'm gonna take my awl and undo the braid on the shield. I'm gonna go straight down one side and clear off a space, and then just bring all the shield over to one side. Give it a few pulls to straighten it out. I'm going to give a nice tight twist on it. Tuck my shield in a little bit. Now, a guitar cable like the GS6 is going to have a black sleeve over the insulation. This material is conductive, so you want to make sure that you take it out so that you don't have any shorts once you put the plug together. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take some wire strippers, and I'm not even going to push in all the way. I'm just going to cut gently into the black tape and then pull it off. So now I have the insulation exposed. I'll check around to see if there's any little pieces that I need to take out, but it's looking pretty clean. All right, next we want to get our center conductor exposed. We are going to use the 14 gauge on our wire strippers here and go about an eighth of an inch back. I'm going to cut once, turn it, cut again. That way it gets all the insulation off without cutting in to my center conductor. We'll give that another little twist so it's nice and tight. And now we are ready to tin it. So I'm going to get a little solder on my tip, press it onto the conductor to get it a little hot, and then bring it over the solder, let it melt. Now, I'm going to flatten my shield out just a little to make it a little bit easier and give a little bend. Now, I can cut off some of this shield because I don't need the entire length. So I'm going to cut off right about where the insulation starts. I can always make adjustments once I go to put it in the connector. So now we'll get a little solder on our tip, and now we're going to take care of that shield. Now, it can be good to wait a minute or two after you've tinned a cable like this because the conductors can get pretty hot. It's good to let them cool down a little bit before you're putting them directly into the connector. That way you don't have any melting in between the insulation and the shield, which could cause some shorts. Now we're going to grab our vise and get our silent plug into the vise. With the silent plug, you can see here, it has a little metal tab. When that goes down, it activates the cable. When it's up, it shorts the cable, so there's no signal passing through. There's nothing special that you have to do when soldering this, as far as this goes. That action will take care of itself once the cable is done. But there is a small little wire, a piece of gold, on the shield, on the sleeve, that Neutrik wants you to solder your shield to. That's an important aspect, so make sure your shield is placed right where that little tab is. All right, we're gonna pop this in the vise. And we are going to tin the cup and tin the sleeve. A little solder on the tip. Press it on to the sleeve or the shell. Then we're going to fill our cup. All right. Now that we have that tinned, we can attach our cable. So before I go and attach this, I'm going to take a look and see how my lengths are. Both the center conductor and the insulation are a little bit long, so I'm just going to trim them just a little bit to make it easier to solder. That looks like I have a good placement now. Since the shell is so broad on this, I'm going to put the iron on and get the solder to melt before I touch the shield down. Now I've got a nice connection. I'm going to let this sit for just a little bit. Like I said, the conductors can get very hot, so we don't want this to melt through the insulation and cause a short. So I'm just going to give it a minute. You can even get a little blow on it to cool it down. And then once you feel that it's cooled down enough, you can go ahead and solder your center conductor. We'll get the cup hot. And then drop our center conductor in. So now we have a connection with both our shield and our center conductor connected. Again, you can wait a few minutes before you put the boot and the outer shell on, just to give that a moment to cool down so that you're not squeezing it too tight and having them push into each other. The chuck here has a little tab on it. The tab can be very important. If you have a smaller diameter cable, that tab you want to keep on, because that will keep the chuck and the boot in place. With a cable like the GS6, the diameter is a little bit bigger. So we're going to cut this tab out so that the connector closes cleanly. So now we can put our chuck on the cable. It's going to come butt up right to the black plastic on our plug. And then we have our shell. And you should see the chuck go all the way up inside the shell. Bring our boot up. And there we go. We have our silent plug on our guitar cable. So this end is ready. Now for the other end, it's the same process. There's nothing really different about it. It's just a different style of connector. So that goes the same. And then your end result is a nice, beautiful cable like this. You've got your red for your instrument end, you've got your black for your amplifier or your guitar pedals. And now if we take a continuity tester, we can demonstrate the function of the silent plug. Right now, we can see here, if we hold the sleeve on one side and touch the tip on the other, it is shorted to itself. Now, if we hold down that tab and hold on to the shield, we see we've got continuity to the shield, but not to the tip. And then if we check the tip, continuity on the tip, not on the sleeve or the shell. Great little function. Neutrik's made a really great connector with this. Very, very helpful when you're on stage. I hope you got some great information out of this. Be sure to leave some comments. Let us know how we're doing. And thank you for tuning in.